Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. Last night, something very weird happened with a future operator skin that was supposed to be releasing in just a few days now. This operator skin was also prominently shown in promotional material. It had a couple of screenshots, and it was prominently shown on the front cover of the newest update for season 4.5. This operator is the one I'm talking about, the one that fully turns your character into a dog. The furry fandom was definitely all over this when it was first announced, and unfortunately, this is probably never going to come to the game now. So as time went on, people were wondering what the heck happened. Why was every instance of this operator scrubbed from the internet and deleted from the Call of Duty accounts? And, well, it turns out that it could have potentially been stolen. There is an artist on Artstation by the name of Sail Lin. Now, this particular artist uploaded a bunch of images 2 years ago in regard to a project that they were working on called the Monster Army. This features a bunch of different animals, including polar bears and tigers and sheeps and Dobermans. They're all in modern military gear. Each one of them seemingly have their own class and what they are representative of within the outfits that they're using. And of course, the class that they're representing. And through all of this artwork that Sail had created over on the ArtStation account, one animal in particular stuck out to those who were investigating, trying to get to the bottom of this, and they just so happened to find this image right here showing a female Samoyed that is supposed to be a medic. This concept art shows them as a medical specialist in the field. So when you look at this image and you compare it to one of the officially released images that Call of Duty put out there, you can definitely see quite a few resemblances in the scarf. You can see it in the outfit color itself. It looks like a very similar color. There's even a patch on the arm that looks like it would be a medical patch. However, the term medic has been removed altogether. There are definitely some changes here. Like, for example, when you look at the face of the operator, you can see that there's some markings in the ear and on the face, and that doesn't exist in the original art. However, it wasn't transformed enough. So personally, this is what I think happened. One of the artists, or multiple artists, that were working on this particular project in order to release it into the shop probably used this image as a reference image. Probably said, yeah, that's a cool idea for an operator. How do we transform that into the Call of Duty space? The problem is they didn't transform it enough. They didn't change it enough. And it still resembles the original image that was posted over 2 years ago by a creator that has no association with Activision whatsoever. And by Activision removing all of these posts and removing the images and changing the cover images and any reference of this operator existing in the game, I think that they're probably going to pull the Ravenov treatment. They're probably just going to remove it quietly from the files and pretend like it never even happened. That's probably going to be what ultimately ends up happening, and we'll never see this operator in-game. Alternatively, what they could end up doing is just removing it temporarily, removing any reference of what it used to look like, and then turning around and transforming it into something completely different from the original concept that was allegedly stolen from. Maybe changing up the outfit, maybe giving it an effect or something else like we've seen with other operator skins, making it an ultra outfit instead of just a normal legendary or epic, and that could be the change that it needs in order to make its way into the game. And trust me, there's plenty that can be done. Obviously, the idea of an anthropomorphic animal isn't new by any means, so there's plenty of stuff that can be done to transform this character to make it even more unique. But at this point, I wouldn't be surprised if they ended up scrapping it. Alternatively, maybe it will just release into the game. We don't really know just yet. It was also brought to my attention last night for the first time, and I had not thought about this in such a long time. My friend Sal over on Twitter mentioned that the Shadows of Evil Max Ammo logo was removed because it originally came from a cover of a Lovecraft book. This is what that Max Ammo logo looks like, and this is what the cover of the Lovecraft book looks like. So it was because of this that it was quietly removed and really never mentioned, and I totally forgot about this logo. Like, I remember seeing it, and then I remember it wasn't there, and I thought maybe it was just something to do with zombies because it's always kind of cryptic in certain things, and, you know, faces and weird logos and stuff always appear, but never really put two and two together until I saw this tweet last night and my mind was blown. And I'm sure that there's plenty more instances of this happening without us ever really knowing it. I'm sure that the legal team at Activision have caught a lot of these things. But then think about the stuff that was quietly removed, like the Lovecraft thing we just got done talking about. I had no idea that's why that was removed. There's probably dozens, if not hundreds of more of instances where things were handled quietly and secretly, and maybe even before the update came through, they probably removed specific things. Now, of course, as to the concept art that was posted by Sail Lin over 2 years ago, I don't know if this actually made it into media. I don't know if this made it into a movie or a game because, of course, it is concept art. I don't know if it was something that was ever entirely used. And if that's the case, I really do feel like this is an opportunity for the Call of Duty team and Activision to reach out to this particular artist. First and foremost, apologize. I would think that they would want to apologize. And secondly, I think that they should offer Sail a job. I mean, looking at some of the concept art, things are incredible here. And I think that this person could be a valuable asset not only to the Call of Duty team, but for anything that they work on in the future. Now, alternatively, if Sail doesn't want anything to do with Activision, which is totally understandable, I'm sure that Activision can write enough zeros on a check to possibly purchase this concept art if it isn't already being used in another project. And if that's the case, then they would be able to have this on their backlog as artwork that they can reference without having to worry about situations like this happening. Now, obviously, that's not going to happen. None of that's going to happen. I think it's just going to be swept under the rug. Things are going to be deleted, and that's going to be the end of it. Maybe we'll see the operator come back looking completely different, but I'm not really holding my breath considering we're so close to the end of Vanguard. So the one thing that I'm curious about in regard to this entire situation is, how did this even get on the radar of Activision? What made them quickly do a 180 and reverse everything? What was that first initial contact point? Was it people within the community putting two and two together saying, hey, this looks like it's stolen from Sail Lin? Was it Sail Lin themselves reaching out to Activision and providing context and saying, hey, this looks like my artwork, please remove it or we're going to have problems? You know, the legal team at Activision is usually pretty damn good about this type of stuff. They're usually incredibly thorough when it comes to things that they're reviewing. I've had to work with the legal team before by doing videos for the CDL and having those appear on the CDL channel. So I know how meticulous they can be and, you know, nitpicking on every little thing, and you need to make sure that it's perfect or else it won't be able to be released. And in this case, that operator skin was appearing in multiple photographs. It was appearing on the front cover of this update. It was appearing pretty much everywhere. And I guess in this instance, mistakes were made. But, you know, with the legal team and the process that's going to be happening in the background, I don't think we're ever going to know about it. Unless there's like a huge lawsuit, which I don't think that's going to be the case. I don't think there's going to be a lawsuit. I don't think there's going to be anything about this. And as of creating this commentary, I haven't seen anything publicly stated by Sail Lin, the original artist, if that art was the one that was used as reference. But anyway, I want to just say this before we close out here. Visit Sail Lin's Artstation account, linked in the description below. There's a ton of incredible stuff to see over there. I highly recommend checking it out. If you guys enjoyed this video today, drop a like on it. Subscribe for more videos coming every single day. And if you haven't yet, don't forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. Let me know your thoughts in the comments section below. What do you think happened in this particular situation? Was the art stolen? Do you think they transformed this character enough? Do you think that they just didn't want to play with fire? I'd love to know your thoughts in the comments section, and I will catch you all on the next one. Peace.